Oh, Nikolai has a new newscast episode.
Video with your friends and colleagues. The next episode will be hosted by either Jose or Billy. I'll see you again in 4 weeks. So long!
Oh, okay. Hello, and welcome everyone to this week's Inside Java Newscast, where we cover the latest developments in OpenJDK. I'm your host, Billy Carando, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle. Today we'll be covering three topics. First, how the JDK will be getting its own web server. Second, incremental improvements to the JVM. And third, the second round of preview for pattern matching for switch expressions. So let's get going. JDK enhancement proposal, JEP 408, specifies a simple web server to be packaged with the JDK, Java Development Kit. As the name of the JEP suggests, the simple web server is just supposed to be that, simple. It was built on the CommSunNet HTTP server package that has been part of the JDK since 2006. The web server only handles GET and HEAD requests, with all the request types returning a 405 or 501. The web server serves only static content and only serves HTTP, so no HTTPS. The goal is to provide a web server with the absolute minimum of ceremony involved. This helps fulfill the common need for students and newcomers to Java of being able to serve static pages. However, even seasoned Java developers will likely find the simple web server useful for local testing and development. The server can be started from the command line with java-m-jdk.hcp-server. This might actually be getting easier pretty soon, as there's currently an open PR for a new JDK tool, JWebServer. So everywhere I'm using java-m-jdk-hcp-server can likely be replaced with JWebServer in the future. So as it turns out, JWebServer has actually been integrated since I recorded that video. So that future I was talking about is actually now. Running this command will start the server on the loopback address http://127.0.0.1 and port 8000, serving files from the directory the command was executed from, and the MIME types will be automatically configured, so a file ending in .html will be served as text.html, while a file ending in Java will be served as text plain. Though this can be customized via the JavaNet URL connection get file name map API. On the subject of customization, the web server can take several optional arguments, -p for setting the port number, -b for the binding address, -d for the directory, which can also be a remote directory, -o for setting console output level, none, verbose, and info, with the default being info, and -h for help, which can show these options. To stop the server, simply hit Ctrl+C or Command+C for Mac users in your terminal window. Currently, JEP 408 is targeted for JDK 18, but there's always a chance for things to change, so you know, don't take my word for it. The new command line tool is great and offers some customization options, but what if you need customization options beyond what is available in the command line? We are developers after all, and we like to tinker. Luckily, there is an extendable API available that fills the gap between the command line options and writing your own implementation of CommSunNet HTTP server. This API is composed of three new classes: Simple File Server, HTTP Handlers, and Request, all located under CommSunNet HTTP server package. The Simple File Server has three static methods: create file server, create file handler, and create output filter that can create a file server handler, and a filter, respectively. The new request interface provides a simpler API for working with requests than what is provided by HTTP exchange, which describes the full and mutable state of an exchange. The new class HTTP handlers has two static methods as well, handle or else, and of. The handle or else method takes a request predicate and two HTTP handle arguments. The predicate can expect the request, and if the request fulfills the predicate, the first handler will be used. And second, if the predicate is false. Of allows for creation of handlers with a preset response state. Finally, the filter class in CompSun NetHTTP Server has also been updated with the static method adapt request, which offers the ability to inspect and adapt a request before it is handled. These new APIs allow for an easy way of customizing a handler that can even be accomplished in JSON. Though of course you can use all of these new APIs in an IDE of your choice as well. For more information on the new simple web server and the new API provides, be sure to check out its GEP. While new language features like records, switch expressions, text blocks, and others often dominate the conversation when covering a new JDK version, less covered, but possibly more important, are the steady improvements made to the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine, with every new version of the JDK. With JDK 17, one such change that caught some attention was an improvement to string.format that increased its throughput by about threefold. While usually individual changes like the string.format change may not always have a measurable impact in the performance of a real-world application, collectively, these JVM improvements can make a substantial difference, a point that Stefan Johansson shows well in a recently published article comparing the garbage collectors between JDK 8, 11, and 17. Stefan shows how there has been significant improvements across throughput, latency, pause times, and memory usage in JDK 17 over JDK 8 and even JDK 11. A link to this article is in the description. If you would like us to cover more improvements to the JVM in detail, let us know in the comments. On the subject of new language features, one of the big stories in the upcoming releases of Java is pattern matching. Pattern matching is a concept of having a match predicate, and if that predicate is met, assigning the value to the pattern variables. The next chapter in that story of pattern matching for Java is a second preview for pattern matching for Switch, which is covered in JEP 420. There are two changes from the first preview, JEP 406. The first change is dominance checking now forces a constant case label to appear before a guarded pattern of the same type for readability. And the second change is exhaustiveness checking of switch blocks is now more precise with sealed hierarchies where the permitted direct subclass only extends an instantiation of the sealed superclass. Well, that about does it for this week of the Inside Java Newscast. Help spread the word about our content by liking and sharing with your friends and colleagues. If you want to stay up to date on the latest developments in OpenJDK, be sure to subscribe as well. Nikolai will be back next episode. I'm Billy saying so long!